Hey everyone, Scott Davenport here. So this video is about a lull that I noticed that I have in my photography, specifically to do with workshops. Before I explain all of that, I want to find out from you what type of lull that you might have in your photography. I could guess that anyone that lives in a place that has more seasons than I do, I basically have, you know, warm season and slightly less warm season. If you've got winter, that's probably a built-in lull where you're staying indoors. But what does that make you do? Does it make you shift up your type of photography? Are you doing more, you know, indoor work, or, you know, I don't know, water droplets on things, or are you into snow photography? I'm curious to hear, you know, if you notice any types of patterns in your photography where you have a lull. Maybe it's seasonally induced, maybe it's self-imposed, and I'll kind of talk about, at least for me, why I think part of my lull is self-imposed. So leave the comments below, or if you want to keep it private, you can contact me through my website. So what did I notice here? Well, I'm starting to do some planning for 2019 workshops, and I realized, wow, I don't have any workshops that I'm hosting basically all summer. I finished up the last San Diego one in April. I have another one in September, and there's still a couple of spaces left if you want to come out for that. And, you know, occasionally I'll do a one-on-one, you know, usually maybe once a month I'm doing a private lesson with somebody. But other than that, there's no hosted workshops. And it's like, well, that's interesting. I wonder why that is. And as I thought about it, I think partially this is self-imposed, partially, at least for doing things locally, it's climate imposed. So the self-imposed part, my children get out of school. We like to spend a little more time as a family. And now, of course, as they get older in their school career, there are more summer activities related to gearing up for college and things like that. So we tend to be having a little more structure and focus on things. So for me to disappear for 2 weeks somewhere to go do a workshop, a little more challenging. And, you know, hey, they're not going to be home forever. So I'll be able to do that when they're off, you know, getting their degrees and becoming the next generation of super brains for the planet. The other part of it is climate induced. I could do more in San Diego, but from the months of May through about the first week of August, maybe the second week, the weather is not particularly conducive for great landscapes. Beautiful outside, wonderful to go to the beach, great place to vacation. But we have May gray, kind of get an idea of what the skies are doing there. We have June gloom, once again, kind of get an idea what the skies are doing there. And then into July and August, the skies are very blue. They're very empty, not very many clouds. So that's not really the best times to host things. So I find that I'm doing planning. And what am I planning for 2019? I've got a trip in a few weeks to the Big Sur, you know, Carmel, Monterey area. Very much looking forward to that. I'll spend a few days just being out there with my camera. But as you know, part photo trip for myself, but part scouting. And that involves a lot more mundane activities. Well, not mundane. They're necessary. They're very necessary if I'm going to host a workshop. But it's things like just, you know, logistics, how easy it is to access places, either by car or on foot. You know, what type of hiking is involved? Would I gauge the hike as strenuous, you know, moderate, or easy? Inclination becomes a factor. What are the temperatures like? And the evenings, is the light jacket needed? Does it get windy? What's the restaurant situations like? Where can I have a group stay? Where can I host a group to have post-processing sessions? You know, all that kind of stuff gets wrapped up in looking at a location from the point of view of a workshop. You know, how do I navigate around? And of course, where are the good photo spots? So that's something that I'm looking at, and I'm sure I'll have a report on that for you after I finish the trip. Another place I'm looking at is Acadia National Park on the east coast of the U.S. Now, I've not done a workshop or hosted a workshop on the east coast, and I really want to go to Acadia Park. I don't know if that one's going to get locked in yet. It'd be toward the end of the year as far as me just going and visiting. Again, I would consider a workshop there in 2019, but me being the guy that I am, I got to get boots on the ground first, personally. I can do a lot of research online, and I've talked to many photographers that have been there. I've seen the wonderful photos that are there. But for hosting a group, if I'm going to host a group, I need to be able to make it smooth. So maybe that's my little bit of advice as far as, you know, I always like to have something that you're going to take away and as a learning event from one of my photos. I don't care who you're going to take a workshop, because there's lots of great workshops out there, at least lots of great locations where workshops are. Do a little research on the instructor. Do a little research on whoever's hosting it. And, you know, just get a feel for, you know, how organized is it? Have they done the research? Have they done that workshop many times? Have they done it in the time that you're going? Where I think that's kind of important. You know, I don't want to go on a workshop with someone that, say, they've researched the location in spring, but we're going in the fall. Those seasons can be very different. So when I'm looking at workshops, I like to do them in within, like, I don't know, I would say 6 weeks on either end of where I've visited and been there, because then I have a better appreciation for what nature might throw around and what the photo locations are going to look like when I visited them, say, the previous year. That's how I did Oregon. You know, the Oregon workshops were a year in the making because I had to go out there and see the place for myself. At the time, I wanted to bring people there. I need to wait a year for that time to come around again. But yeah, don't just look at the workshop itself. The locations are going to be great, but take a look at the what the instructor's done on their homework up front and ask them questions, grill them. Do the same thing. If you're thinking about coming on a workshop with me, do not be shy about firing off emails and saying, Scott, what about this? What about that? Have you done this? You know, I'm happy to answer all of those types of things. And then you can gauge for yourself. Am I, you know, is it worth it to go on that particular workshop or not? I think that's enough. I think I've talked enough. I've rambled enough. I'm going to get back to some more planning here. And thanks for watching. I'll see you again soon. Happy shooting.